And good morning, welcome. Hey, I'm Dan Renfro, pastor of recovery at New Hope Church on Xenia Avenue in Dayton, Ohio. It's 9 a.m. on Saturday morning, and every Saturday we move from 8 a.m. our weekly broadcast. And we move to a recovery. We moved to 9 a.m. because nobody's awake at 8 a.m., I don't think. I don't know. I look out this window, a lot of movement. I can see I-35 is right outside my window, and I can see downtown. We move to all the things on the horizon. The dump, which is beautiful from here. It's just it's all in perception. I look out this window, a lot of movement. Good morning. Thank you so much for being here this morning. Welcome. I'm sharing this to all of our pages. If you're on any page except for my home page, Pastor Dan Renfro, and you put in the comments, for some reason they don't show up here. But if you come to my homepage and join in from there, then your prayer and all those things will show up. So look forward to you coming there, and so that we can see you when you get there. I'm just going to get caught up here. Just give me 2 seconds. If you come to my homepage, I'm going to make sure that we're not getting the double thing that we got the other day here. Today we're going to do devotions. We'll have prayers in just a little bit. Again, put your prayers and the prayer requests down in the comments. And wondering how you're doing today. We're going to look about being clean today. Clean on the outside, clean on the inside. We're going to look at a couple different things. First, we're going to take a quick look at the weather. There it is. 28 degrees outside right now. Going to get up 53 today. Overnight 36, back up to 56. For Sunday, that's down 10 degrees from the original forecast. Going to be raining, 60-70% chance of rain over the weekend. And then it's going to continue to rain through the week and get a little bit colder. And, of course, it is as we move through this springtime, this April flowers bring May showers. Or vice versa, however that goes, right? As always, I want to remind you, down in the comments, put your prayer request. Get plugged in to God in prayer, and it's going to be a wonderful day. I want you to remember, no matter how many people are here when you first get here, during the day, literally 100 people come. And if they don't go anywhere else, nobody comes and listens to my mouth, but they do go to the prayers. And they look who they can pray for and put their prayer request in. So if you come back during the day and you look in that area. Now, as you come in, I want to say good morning. Some of you have already missed, but Alexa, Stephanie, Melanie, Vicky, Evelyn, Eric, and is that another Evelyn? Anyway, thank you all for being here this morning. Please say hi in the comments so that you show up during the day. And again, down in the comments, put your prayer. Hey, make sure everybody don't forget today's Saturday Night Live. Our worship series continues through forever, I hope, but at least for this week. And tonight we have Mosaic Band. Mosaic Band, Worship Band will be here tonight. Tracy will be leading worship once again, and she has such the spirit in her. Hopefully she'll tell you a little bit of her story of over the past month, just incredible things going on with her in the spirit. It's an amazing time. Hey, let's go on to the devotion. Went to the devotion. I'm not on the screen. That's pretty interesting. So if you take a look here, we're going to look to Pastor Mark Farley's devotion for this morning. It's his devotional book that he wrote, and he's with me here on Thursdays. It's Faith Through Works Fellowship Daily Devotions from the Bible and the Big Book. And go back over here and see if we can get that to pop up. I'm not sure what's going on up here with our... I'll get that out of the way for now. Okay, so today, March 23rd, I had to check. It has been a great and fantastic fun week. And part of that week has been that, you know, I interact. I don't know if you know, I'm also the pastor at Otterbein Springboro. It's a nursing facility, skilled care facility, and rehab place. And so I have people that we talk every day and we interact. And I told somebody on a text message the other day, she's She's like, I'm 62 and she's at least 80. And I say, hey, it's going to be Easter this weekend. And she's like, dude, hey, you need to, you know, you need to get back to reality or whatever. So anyway, it is not going to be Easter this weekend, but a month from tomorrow, it will be Easter. Let's look at the devotion today. Today, Mark is talking about, are we clean on the inside? No matter how many times we wash and our cars, he's talking about, I better go back up here. No matter how many times we wash and wax our cars, it never will cure and then fix the engine problem. Whatever we fix on the outside is not fixing on the inside. Now, most of us understand this, and that's why we change oil frequently, find a garage or mechanic we can trust to keep our cars running well. Are we doing the same for our internal spiritual engine? So today, as we look today, that's what we're going to set up. What are we doing for our internal spiritual engine? It's great to be all dressed up and cleaned up on the outside, but that doesn't fix our inner mental and spiritual health. Most folks can see through our superficial look to look good, to feel our brokenness. Brokenness, that word has just appeared to me over and over again. I made a little meme for our thing tonight that, are you broken? Well, we have the glue. Come see us tonight at 5 o'clock and we'll show you the glue. The glue is Jesus. Who's your spiritual mechanic? Check your experience. Now then, you Pharisees, clean the outside of the cup and dish, but the inside are full of greed and wickedness. Luke 11:39. Lord, let us bring our hearts and our spiritual mind to you daily for a spiritual checkup and refreshment. Amen. Our sound reasoning failed to hold us in check, the big book tells us. You know, when we try to control things ourselves, we generally just don't do a good job. I want to look closer at that passage from Luke. We're going to back up a couple of verses. I always like to see that if you really want to understand the Bible verse that somebody's telling you, you have to back up to go forward. And that's what we're going to do today. So we're going to go back to 37. It says, when Jesus had finished speaking, the Pharisee invited him to eat with him. So he went in and reclined at the table. They kind of laid down at the table. If you've seen the picture of the Last Supper, that's why everybody seems to be, their head seems to be on the person beside him, because they're reclined. But then the Pharisee was surprised when he noticed that Jesus did not first wash before the meal. And if your kids are listening to this, I'm sorry, and they tell you next time Jesus didn't wash. Then the Lord said to him, now then, you Pharisees, clean the outside of the cup and dish, but inside you're full of greed and wickedness. You foolish people. Did not the one who made the outside make the inside also? But now as for what is inside you, be generous to the poor, and everything will be clean for you. Very interesting that Jesus is the man. He's looking at our hearts. The Bible says that God looks at our thoughts and our intentions. Amen. So today, let's look inside. Let's look at our thoughts and our intentions. Let's look at the way that we, not just the way we act and look, but how do we feel? What are our thoughts and intentions? Amen. Let's be in prayer. Today, our prayer, if we take a look, oh my goodness. What if I just do that? No, I can't do that. All right, I'm not sure if I can even fix that on this thing. Here we go. And let me try to fix it here. I have like a really crazy setup here. It looks like every day the devil, I call him the cyber devil, because every day something comes up, something happens that he kind of attacks this broadcast, which I wondered if I was doing the right thing doing this broadcast, because I really want to do it and I love the technical part of it, and I keep building and scavenging to build it up. And when I started seeing all these things happen that shouldn't happen, that I felt like it was spiritual warfare, then I knew for sure that this was the right thing to do. Hey, let's be in prayer today. If you look at our prayer list up here, There are a lot of people on the prayer list. If you want to get on the prayer list, Bud McKinney, who generally joins us, he may be off on the run this morning. But if you leave a message, he will put you on this prayer list. He'll redo this one, and we'll get it tonight. He passes those out at the recovery worship after recovery worship at the meeting. We have a 12-step Christian recovery meeting every Saturday night after worship, after the dinner. Then we get together for an hour starting about 6:30. You're invited to all of it or any piece of it. We'd love to have you there. You don't have to come to worship to eat. You don't have to come to eat to get to the meeting. You can come to any part. But if you come tonight with and listen to Tracy and the Mosaic Band, they are truly blessed. The Spirit will fill you up and all. You'll want to stay for all the pieces. So let's look. Today is the 23rd. We want to pray. I'm glad he put us on here. I can always use your prayers. The church certainly can use your prayers. Unless, in case you don't know it, we're a missionary church. That means the people who work there, they get paid, they raise their own salaries so that because, you know, we're in a situation where the congregation can't necessarily support the church financially. We support the church in all kinds of service ways and reaching out. But we go just like if I was going to Africa or any other place to bring the word, we do that same thing. So my point is, we would love for you to come down and we need your prayers. And let's look at the whole list today. Make sure you're praying for Jeff tomorrow and then everybody that's on this list. And we just take a look real quick at the prayer request down here. Hello, Ken, Steve, welcome. Tom Balin, Grandpa, man, I'm just so excited for you. Every time I see your name, and I see little Oliver in my, it's really great. Good morning, Miss Sarah, one of my most favorite people of all time. Sharon, thank you for coming back today. I'm loving, we're still eating the same stuff that we were eating 2 days ago. And Scott, thank you so much for being here. Ken, thank you all for being here. Again, I want to pray for you specifically today. I'd ask you to just put your hands up towards the prayer list, but even more, turn your hands this way, because we want our prayers to go up and our love to go up, and then as he drops that blessing, we want to receive that blessing. Let's be in prayer. Dear Lord, Father God in heaven, you are the utmost God of all the earth, the heavens. You invented it all. You created it all. You made us. Thank you, Lord, so much. Thank you for guiding our days. Lord, we ask you today, the word beseech you today, that you would come for these people that are on this prayer list today. The people that have joined us for this broadcast, whether they're still here or not, Lord, we ask you to touch them, hug them, put your arms around them, hold them up. Lord, we ask you to drop your blessings down to us. Fill us up with your love. Give us the strength to go another day. Lord, we pray for the people who are battling addictions, whatever that is, drugs, alcohol, what a gambling, sexual addictions, men, women, whatever it is, food, Lord, with bad thoughts, wanting to hurt themselves and other people. Lord, we had asked you, did you take the devil and you press him away and get him out of our lives and put him behind us and give us the strength, Lord. Take the thoughts of suicide and hurting ourselves and the thought of hurting other people in other ways, not even physical, Lord, and whatever that is, take that away. Let us be planted in your love. I pray specifically today. I put my hand on the people that are here today, Lord, that you just fill them with your love and you fill them with your direction. You fill them with your everlasting healing. Lord, I pray for today for Dory. Please, Lord, take the pain from her. Give her the strength for another day. Make the food be able, her to be able to eat the food. And Lord, let her gain some weight. Lord, take the pain. Lord, I pray today for everybody that will come by this broadcast today, whether they come in or not, that they'll be blessed by the presence of you inside here. Lord, I pray in the name of the risen Christ, Jesus Christ, amen. Amen. Okay, I won't sing because there's a couple of you left and I don't want you to leave. Hey, thank you so much for being here today. I want to remind you on Thursdays, we have a talk show that is about living life on life terms. It talks about how Jesus works in our life, whether we're in recovery of active addiction or we're in active recovery, whatever we're in recovery from. Is it and Mark Farley, who wrote the devotion that we're in today, wrote that book. He joins me for an hour on Thursdays. Today at 11 o'clock, we just have a 30-minute discussion. If you come in, we answer your questions. If not, we're going to look deeper into cleaning the outside and the inside and just kind of talk about things that are going on in the recovery world today. We invite you into that. We're so glad that you come and visit us. We really would implore you. Hey, we really would love if you would come to our worship service. If you're not going to anywhere tonight, if you're on your way out to dinner, I would be glad. Mosaic brings the food, and the food is incredible. They bring the worship, and you don't have to listen to me. I don't preach on the night that they're here. I just sit back and I soak up this blessing that they bring. Tracy, this young worship leader, has for the past few years has been leading worship, and she's coming into her own. The Spirit is filling her up so powerfully, and you will be blessed to hear her. So come by, hear her, stay for dinner, stay for the meeting. You would be a blessing. Whether you have the people at this meeting are in some kind of active recovery from addiction that's touched them not very long ago, bring your experience, strength, and hope of how Jesus has changed your life, whether it's been drugs or alcohol or whatever that he saved you from, and help wrap it around all the people there. We need your love. Thank you again so much for being here. And I don't know if anybody's told you today that Jesus loves you, but Jesus loves you, and so do I.